Hello, my friends. Welcome back. So happy to have you again. We got a cool painting here that we're going to jump into, an 18 by 24 cliffside looking over the lake and the mountains, as you can see. A lot of fun to do, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. Let's also hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell, and that way when I'm posting something new, you'll be the first to hear it. So let's jump on the painting. Can't wait for you to try it. And we'll see you at the end. Hey, everybody, and welcome aboard. It's good to have you here. Sitting in my studio and wanted to put together a painting, and I wasn't going to do a tutorial, but I figured, what the heck, let's roll the cameras and talk. So let me show you what I've done here so far. I have an 18 by 24 stretched canvas. And what I did was, I did with a pencil, just a rough sketch of where I wanted my land to be, and maybe the horizon line back here. Just a rough outline of the mountains. That could all change. Wanted to make it a little small. We can get bigger, but trying to keep it about like that. So, but just putting some black gesso with a, you know, little filbert brush here, just to, so I can save my outline when I do my sky and water. I'll go right over that, but then I'll still be able to see where I want the coast to go. So this will be a big cliff, and you know, pretty far down the water there, we won't be able to see it. So hopefully it turns out okay. So we're going to get started. I am not completely sure what colors I'm going to use in this. Probably, you know, most of your regulars, but I like to put them on my palette as I go. And that way I don't put a big pile of red on there, and then I don't use the red, so I don't waste any paint. So we're going to get started with the sky. So to start with, I have some Prussian blue and some black. That is the Gamblin ivory black. So we're going to use our 2-inch brush here. This is my Paint with Bram 2-inch brush. Great brushes. Highly recommend if you're looking for a brush set. This is the one to get, the 1-inch, 2-inch fan brush, filbert. The liner is fantastic, and the little blender is great too. So highly recommend these. So we're going to go into some Prussian blue. Just the tips. Tap it in really good, and come over here and steal a little bit of midnight, or the ivory black. So much more blue than black. And we'll just tap that out real good. See what we got. Let's come up here to the corner, and here I'm going to kind of use kind of like these rocking motion strokes. Kind of makes a cool sky, and we'll make it look like it's kind of going off into the distance here, and we'll get lighter and lighter. And a little closer together as we go down. Less pressure as we move down the horizon. We want this sky to be a little darker. We'll put some nice white clouds over top. And just bring that down. That's fine. Like that. Gonna get a little more color, a little more of the blue. The straight blue here. Come up and hit the corner a little bit. Come across the top. Harsh lines here. And then we'll get lighter as we go down. Stretch that out. And then this can be very free. Just be very free with it. Just put the color in. Don't sweat it. Don't worry about it. Just have fun with it. Okay. There we go. Now for the water, we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to add a little phthalo green to my palette. Just can come in here and grab some of this phthalo green, and then go into that blue. Prussian blue and phthalo green. And this is going to be for our water. So I like to tap that real good. That way you don't gob your paint. All right, so let's go over here. And we're going to cover some of this up, but that's okay. We'll redefine it. So we'll come on the outside. We don't need to come down here, but our water is going to be here. And we're just going to pull this to the inside, straight across. Same thing on this side. We're going to leave a little bit of light in the middle there. So again, don't worry about this. We'll cover that up. Just come from the outside in. Leave this middle section feathered. Add a little more color, especially down here. There we go. Good. Then we'll come back with a clean brush, dry. Just use a 2-inch brush. When I blend my water, I like to start here on the feathered edge. Smooth that out, then work your way out so that we don't pull any of the darker color inside. So just start here, just kind of like this, flicking back and forth. And then go all the way out and across. Good. And then we're going to come up to the sky, and we'll start around the mountain. You can use X's, circles. We're just going to knock down that color a little bit. Again, I like to leave some of these brush strokes in here. Don't blend them all away. They look cool. There we go. Run that out. Piece of the cotton canvas sticking out there. That's all right. Bring that over. There we go. She's gone. All right, then come up to this section where it's a little darker. And again, leave some of those brush marks in there. I mean, if you like it real smooth, you can certainly knock them out. That's fine. But I find if you leave some of that action in there, it looks really cool. Bring this blue down a little bit. If you want this area a little darker, steal some of this here and just bring it down. You don't need to go get more paint. Okay, same thing here. Steal a little bit of this paint and you can bring it down. But I want to have this little line here. I don't want to destroy that. Okay, good, and then gently go across. Kind of get all your brush marks out of there from your swirls. Okay, very good. I'm gonna come up here and add a little more color right here with a little blue. Oops. Come on, blue. I know you're in there. There it is. Just a wee bit. I'm gonna make this a touch darker here. Just a little bit darker. And this little lighter as we get over here. Good. And just blend that all the way across. And here I'm just bringing this little bit of this blue up around the base of the mountain. So you have a little background color there. Blender. Just blend that out a wee bit. Good. All right. You're all set. All right, now we're going to put some clouds in. So I'm going to use my filbert brush here and pull through some of this titanium white. Just load up both sides. A good amount of paint. Okay, and we'll come up here. And I'm going to follow kind of the outline of this dark edge a little bit. We'll see where it goes. So let's start here. I'm using little circles. Keep the brush going. It's very important to not stop in one spot. Okay, then I'm going to come back. And with the bottom of this 2-inch brush, we're just going to gently blend out the base of this. Not touching the tops, just the bottom end. Wipe the brush off. It's going to pick up that blue. Get some more color. Maybe he's here. Got to chuck a little in. Maybe this guy's up here. Come back with our 1-inch, and we're just going to tease it. Blend out that base. And the same thing on this side. Off of there. Okay. All I'm going to come back and touch those up a little bit. Okay. Filbert. Get some white. And we're going to touch the tips. A lot of paint. A good amount. And we're going to add a little volume and depth to the cloud. I like to put a lot of paint and texture in these clouds. So I'm just going back and getting white and kind of outlining the tops a little bit. Again, we'll blend this out more. And come to this side. And step back and take a look. Very important to step back and take a peek. Okay. Let's come in with a big 2-inch brush. This is the brush I used to put my clear gel on, so I'm just going to come in here gently. You know what? I'm going to go with. Use my little blender. We're just going to kind of gently kind of fluff. Let's knock it down a little bit. I don't want to take those cool white tops off. Okay, just maybe knock them down a bit. Same thing here, just take the edge off. A couple spots. Fluff. This little paint with brand blender is great for these type things. Love it. It's very soft, and it with this titanium white from the Artist Series Gamblin' It's very hard to blend this Gamblin Titanium White, the Artist Series. Hard to blend it away. You really got to work hard to move it out. Okay. Just gonna fluff it up a little bit. Okay, good. Then come back and just kind of blend the entire cloud, set it down a little bit, very gently. Very gently. Knock this down just a touch. Okay, a little more paint. And let's come under here. Maybe we've just got a couple of these guys. It's it maybe a little further back. Off. And come back with our blender. Just kind of hit these. Back, take a look. Okay, come in here. Gonna reattach some of these spots here. Just a little bit here and there. Add a little more depth to that cloud. And come back and gently blend that. Okay. More shape to a couple of these. Just a little bit. A little more color. Comes up. Down. And here. And it comes down like this. Let's go down here. And then gently blend him out. Right. I'm going to come back with a little bit of the Prussian blue on my blender brush. We'll add a couple darker shadow areas in here. Maybe across the bottom a little bit. Wipe that off. And come in here and stir it up a little bit. Just a couple little things. A few subtleties. One more. Brush. Dark at the bottom. Same thing here, just a little bit color at the base. Just a dab, don't go too much. Get that off. To the cloud a little bit, and this is optional, you don't have to do this. I just like how it adds a little more depth to your cloud. And you could fiddle with these all day. I don't want to stop fiddling. Okay, very good. I think that's good. Some of that blue in there. Tap him in a little more. More white. Just going a little white here. Just bring him out a little bit more, blend it out. Tell you what, maybe he goes right off the canvas this way. All right, just some subtleties there. All right, I think we are good. So now we will jump on this mountain, and I'm going to take some of the mountain mix here. I've got my mountain mix here, and this is a little Payne's gray. So we're gonna pull this mountain mix out. We're gonna add some white to it because I want to lighten it up a little bit. I don't want it quite so dark. So I'll add some white to it. Just pull that out. And let's put that whole pile in there. Okay, let's see what we got. Cut off a roll of paint. And I've already got my main outline here, so I'm just going to kind of go over this again. Let's see what we got here. We can change this. The shape does not have to be exactly the same. Just getting some paint down. Okay, this will definitely come around. I think I'm going to put one little... there. Look at that. Okay. And then we'll follow this line. Bring this down. More. And again, we're just following the outline that I had with the gesso. Sometimes when I do these sketches with a pencil and then I paint over it, then I can't see my sketch anymore because the paint covers it. And then I'm guessing, so I figured this time we'll use gesso instead. Okay, good. Now we're going to scrape all this excess paint off. Scrape it off. Most of it. Let's get rid of that pointy top. And again, when you're doing your mountains, try not to have these TP triangles where they come right to a point and right back down, because you rarely see that in nature. Now, maybe from a far distance it appears more pointy, but usually it's going to be something like that. Just avoid that teepee look, like you got a bunch of tents at the campground. Okay, so we got all that paint off. That's good. Okay. I'm going to wipe off this brush that I was blending with real good. This should be good enough. And we're going to pull this paint down. Remember, we've got that clear gel on here, so it's going to allow this paint to move. We can move it. So let's move it. We'll take it off here. Here, grab it and pull. I like to wipe my brush off in between pulls, so I don't want to bring this mountain down too far. We all know. Mountains can grow on you real easy, and before you know it, your painting's shot because you made your mountain way too big. Let's pull that out. Wipe. And I've said this before, when you're doing this, try and make your color. The reason why we do this, part of the reason, is when I pull this paint down, we want to have it gradually get lighter. When we get down here, with that gradual color value getting lighter here, it'll already look like mist when you don't have to do anything to it. You don't have to add mist to it. So let's pull this down. Okay, and then we'll just blend out the base. Step back. Okay, next step. Take a shop towel. And I want this value not quite as dark. This will be kind of like, I think I'm going to do more of like a gray and black, or grayish mountain, not a snow covered mountain. So we're just going to get rid of this excess paint here. Just rub it off. We'll reblend everything, so don't worry about your marks from your towel. But you can see there's a lot of paint up there, so we can try and get rid of it. Don't go into your sky. Careful. Come up here and just knock off that paint. Went into my sky. Oops. Again, just wiping the paint off. Okay, now we'll come back. Wiped all that off. We'll come back with that same blender brush and we'll re-blend this. Just wanted to get the value a little lighter. Very nice. I think that's good. So I think today I'm going to do this mountain with a filbert brush. Kind of new. Well, I've done some mountains with filberts, but just a little bit different. So we're going to go into some of that Payne's gray. Pretty cool color. And let's come up here and start dropping some of this ridge here. This is going to go straight down here. Okay, good. Excellent. A little more at the top. All right, and then we'll come over here. Some more paint. Again, this is just Payne's gray. This is kind of our base coat here. Comes down like this. And then we'll come here. This will come also straight down. So into the sky a little bit. That's all right. That's how you fix it. Just add another bump. kind of comes out like this. And this goes this way. And then off the back side, a couple of bumps there. Just putting some color in. And lighter down here. He comes down like this. First time doing a mountain this way, so we'll see how it goes. Cut in front of that. Well, it looks kind of cool like that. Maybe we'll leave it. More darkness here. Interesting. Maybe we should leave her like that. What do you think? I don't know. This down a little bit. All right, I'm digging it. The question, do we leave it? Because I like it like that. It looks pretty cool. All right, I'm just dropping a couple. I've made that Payne's gray and added a little bit of white. And I'm just going through here, dropping a couple of highlights. This dark end. Up to the top. Gotta cover this. And then as it goes back here, just a little bit, maybe at the tip, a little light spilling over, not much. I want this dark back there. And again, I'm just dragging my filbert. Just a couple spots here. Make that a little more irregular. that's good. And maybe come out this side a little bit, just to lighten this up a touch. A little more white. Pull this. Just a little bit there. Come back with my blender. I'm just gonna kind of come back up against that a little bit, soften it up. And there we go, a gray mountain. I think I might leave it like that. I think she looks pretty cool. All right, let's move forward. All right, so I think I'm gonna have some grass coming down off of here. So we're gonna go into, got a little bit of this black up here. So grab a little bit of that, or 2 inch, oops, a little too much. It's a little black. Then we'll come down here and go through some of this yellow. And we should get a cool green. Let's go get a little more. Pull that through. A little more black. Add a little more. Hold on, 1 sec. All right, so add a little green to my palette. It's a little more of a green color. Okay. And we're just going to tap into that. Tap, tap, tap. Let's see what we got here. Maybe we'll start over here. Now we need to bring that out a little more. More yellow. Add a little more yellow. So it stands out just a touch. Okay. I need to get some of that excess paint off. See what we got. recessed areas and just tap. Color. Just come out this way and off. And over here, it'll just get lighter and lighter. We're a little further away. A step back. Okay, so now we're going to do a tree line here, but I'm going to come in here and fill all this in. So I've got some mountain mix here. Oops, almost in that gray. We don't want that. So we're just going to load up our 2-inch brush, both sides, and we're just going to come in here and we're going to tap in. All this color. Just tap it in. Careful. Careful on these edges. Should probably use a little filbert brush out. Grab my filbert. Some of this dark color to get some of these lines here. There. Same thing here. Color. There we go. Close that in. Now we'll go back to our big brush. Get some of this paint off. A little thick. This will all be covered, so we're not worried about that. And back to our bigger brush. And we'll just fill this in. Color. And you could even just do this. I do like to tap eventually to get the texture, but just to lay the color down, you can certainly, as Bob would say, you can use a paint roller for this part. Filling in color. You got to have the dark to show the light. Good. That's good enough. Bring this up just a little bit. Okie doke. So now we're going to put in some little, just a little tree lined bank. I've got some sap green here. Maybe put a little bit of the mountain mix in with it. Just darken it up a little bit. I want to have a little green, so a little mountain mix, a little green. You can use my oval brush. Just tap it on there. Okay, we'll come up to this bank. We're going to vary this a little bit. Some sections a little higher, some a little lower. Color again, a little sap green, a little mountain mix. It's got to cover up that line. We can bring this down a little bit. More color. Oh. And we're just tapping this color in. Come with a clean. Maybe I'll just wipe off my other brush. Excuse me, this brush that we use for the highlights or for the blending. And we'll just come through here and just pull down some reflections straight down. And then gently across. Just a little more. Just a little more. And then come back and across. Very good. Then I'm going to come back with a small fan brush. I think it's like a 3. I'm going to go back in this yellow and kind of crunch it. Just tap the top corner of this yellow green. Maybe come over here and get a little more green. I'm just going to spread it out. Just get that end. Go more yellow. Okay, and then with that splayed end, just the top end, I'm going to come in and just touch. A little bit on the tops of these. Here and there. And again, just the top. Touch a few spots. Color. Pull a little bit of that down too. Just here and there. Brush. Knead it out, and then we'll pull this down as well. Doke. And I think I'm going to bring one of these a little bit closer, just so it's not straight across here. So maybe here we'll come in, bring this section a little further down, and then it will go back. Yeah, I like that better. We can pull this down. This one's going to be a little closer to us. I should use my other brush for that. Okay, let's use this one. And then come across. There we go. Okay, that looks a little better. Now we can come in with a small knife and a little bit of titanium white. So I just kind of slice through this. I like to get a little bit on the underside of the knife. And we just need a little bit. So we'll come in here. Maybe we'll start with our first water lines here. Like that. And this one sets back a little bit. Maybe this one too. Just a little more. And that way it gives that feeling of dropping back. Let me straighten this one out. A little more paint, just a little. Really don't need much on your knife. This one's back here a little bit, so this will come over. And then back here. Like that. Maybe he comes a little closer. See, now we've made all these indentations back there, so it doesn't look flat. And you can really just do that with your water lines. Throw this one out a little bit. Yes, I think that looks much better. Again, now we have these little recessed areas where the water goes, and it's not flat across. Okay, let's just take this boy right off the edge. And the same thing here. This little cliff will block that off, so. All right. Very nice, I think. I'm going to come over here and just extend this down a little bit, this reflection. I think most of this will be covered, but just in case something's poking through. I know we did our water line, but that's okay. All right, that's better. I'll come back with the big brush and just gently go across. A little down and across. We don't want to hit this dark paint I got here. That would not be good. All right, that's good. Perfect. All right, so all I did was I filled in, forgot to turn my camera on, of course. I just filled this in dark. We're gonna have grassy edges here and then cliffs coming in, but we need the dark, obviously, to show the light. So I filled in my little tracing that I had there. You can still kind of see where the edges are gonna be. So we'll take care of that. And we've got our, we're all ready. So I may even let this tack up a little bit and then come back and then do our trees and bushes and cliffs and rocks there. So we'll see, maybe I'll jump right in. So let's see what we're gonna do here. Let's take a little bit. Make a little mix of some of my browns here. Got some sienna. Let's see, we'll put a little sienna out over here and we will steal some white. And I'm just going to use my filbert and a little bit of this yellow ochre. Just kind of spin that in there and just more of the sienna, maybe even a little bit of this burnt umber. Try and get a nice marbly mix. A little more of the umber. Good. And a little more of the ochre. And a touch more of the sienna. We'll see how that looks. Okay. So I'm just going to drag my filbert through it. Okay, and then we'll come over here. First cliff we're going to do is over here. And we will just gently kind of pull down. And use the side. We want this to cover this line. We'll fix this line again. It's important. Back here, it'll be a little darker. Something like that. And then we can come back with a little bit of the light mix. And just drag a couple of highlights. We're going to have some grassy areas that hang over that. Take a step back. I'm even going to come back here. I'm going to grab another filbert, a very small filbert, and come back with this dark color. Just want to add a little some dark spots in. That's a little better. Okay, good. And now we'll go over to this little section here. Again, some of that umber, sienna, ochre, a little white. Kind of load that up here. And let's just drag it down the side here. Just kind of like we did with the mountain. We'll have another ledge coming out right here. We can soften that up. We can add a little darker here and there. Okay, good. I mean, this side's our light's coming from here, so this is going to catch a little more light. I'm still going to come back. It's a little dark on this tiny filbert and just accentuate some of these dark areas. A little darker down here. It's got a little bright. And then we're going to have another lip. I'm going to bring this back just a little further. Come back to about there. Bring this down just a little bit. Okay. All right. This next little section here. This will come down here. It's going to catch a little bit of this. This will make sense in a minute when I fill in the land again. Which I'm going to do with my knife. So just take a little bit of this dark color. So this is going to stick it out a little bit right here. Yeah, something like that. It comes back to about here. Knife, a little bit less dark, and just redefine this edge. Good. Let's go to the other side. This other side is going to be darker, so we'll use more umber and sienna here. Looks like this line comes over here. It disappears. Make sure my proportions are correct. Maybe we cut this off a little bit. Like that. And this will come all the way down. just darken this edge. Okay. All right. Oops. Let's button this down a little bit. Let's come back and redefine this edge too. This one right here. Brown paint in there. This will all be covered up, so just trying to get a clean edge there. Grass and trees. Okay, good. All right, next step. Need to lay in some trees. Okay, so let's drop some trees. I'm going to use my smaller filbert. I'll plop maybe a tree here. We're going to have a bigger tree here, so I don't really need to put anything here, but maybe we'll cover this with a couple trees. So we're just going to go into some of this mountain mix, which is again just a mix of all your darks. Load it up, lots of paint. Okay, that may be our first one, maybe we'll have two. So maybe one right here. Okay, we'll get him started. More paint. Sitting a little crooked out there. Good. And we'll give him a buddy. This guy's here. A little taller. Get some paint. And touch. Just touch. And as you come down, work your way side to side. Let's see here. All right, so we'll move a little closer. I'm going to go to my larger filbert for this one. So we'll load up some paint, both sides. Let's see, maybe we'll put this one. He's going to come out right here. So maybe he comes above this peak. And he comes straight down to there. It's a little crooked line, but we'll straighten that out. So let me see here. So start here. And just go. Right there. That way we save the view of our little cliffside there. Come up here. Fill in a little bit. A little bit. like that tree there. Maybe he's got a buddy right next to him. This guy starts here. A little higher. Comes down. We'll be able to pull him out a little bit with some highlights. We're just working our way back and forth, covering some of our trees, or distant trees, but that's okay. Comes down a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Like him there. We'll come to the other side and we'll start working our way forward. So maybe over here. Oops. Kicking my camera. Come to this side. Maybe, let's see here. We'll have a bigger tree here to cover this. So maybe he's a little closer and he's just going to break the top. Oops. Maybe he comes down to there. Okay, so we're just going to touch with the corner to start. And then we can bring the brush a little bit closer together. And again, just back and forth. Flip for more color. More paint. Maybe about right there. Again, he's gonna have a bigger boy there, so we're not gonna worry about that too much. Come over here and let me see here. Fatten him up a little bit. There we are. All right, very nice. I like that so far. Very good. And we'll put some, I think we'll put some grass in there as well. So let's start doing that a little. Well, let me see here. Maybe we'll plop a big one next to him. Let's come in here. This next one, he's going to be a taller boy. We'll start him up here. Get in the way of my camera, but I don't want a crooked tree either, so my apologies if I get in your way. And going side to side, this filbert makes perfect shapes for your hangy downs. Flip it. Work out a little further each time, as we always like to say. Get some more paint. And I tell you, I started this painting, you probably don't know it, last night, and then I stopped and I let all this dark tack up in the mountain, of course, and stuff. And boy, it does make a difference when you go to paint when that's had a day to dry a little bit, or tack a little bit. Your paint comes off much better and you're not fighting the paint that's already under there. So I'll bring this down. Maybe he comes down to about there. We will see. Coming that side. Okay. Need to come down to the other side. So we'll come over here. We're going to cover this end. So again, reload. More paint. So this one's maybe going to come down to here. So we'll come up here as well. It's going to be a taller tree. Maybe it starts about here. So we'll just start it there. Color. Come down here. Moving down further. Down here, it's all dark. It really doesn't matter. We will separate that with highlights, but just to give us a basic idea where the tree will end up. So I'm thinking maybe about right there. So I don't know if you can see that, but it's a good spot. And there's things you want to think of, you know, it'd be nice just to plot more trees, but we also don't want to block some of the cool things that we got in here. So, I'm digging that. Like, sure, it'd be nice to have another big tree right here, but then I cover that up and I think take away a little of the depth that we have. So I think I'm going to leave that there. And we can put some rocks and some bushes and stuff that'll surround all of that. So that should look okay. Let's get a little dark paint here. Looks brown with the glare, but we'll cover it. It'll be covered with grass. Alright. Now, before we get too far along here, I need to come back and fill in some of these grassy areas back here. I could have done it first, and I was going to lay my grass straight across, then you bring the trees down over the grass. So sometimes we can sneak in the grassy areas, and then when we highlight the trees, everything will look okay. So, I'm going to use, for some of these tighter areas back here, I'm going to use this fan brush. Let me see if I got a better candidate. So many fan brushes. This one might be a little better. Find a fan, old Bob fan brush has got a flat head, and believe it or not, I do believe this is a 6. Yeah, it's a 6, and I've got other bobs that are 6s that are way bigger and rounded, so that sometimes the quality went downhill a little bit. But we're going to go into, let's see here, we'll pick up a little bit of this dark color that we used for all of our base here, and we'll come into the a little yellow here, and I'm going to steal a little sap green and a touch of phthalo green, just a touch for this side anyways, and let's see if this sticks. We're going to push and get a little ridge of paint on the edge of that. Let's see what this looks like. So let's come in here and we'll just touch gently. Wait a minute. Make sure my camera's on. A little touch right here. in front of these trees. Good. And then back here, I'm going to make this a little darker. Especially for behind these trees here, so to touch. Just go above that dark a little bit. Just tapping here. A little more color. Maybe this is a little more highlighted here. A little darker there. Walk that over. Bring out a couple spots. Kind of like the grassies coming over the edge there. I'm gonna come back with a little darker paint. Behind this tree, so darken this up a little bit. Get a little more in shadow. Same thing behind him. A little darker. A little shadow there. Like that. Okay, that's a little better. A little bright. All right, good. Now, a little bit away from there, we can go to our 1 inch, and again we're going to go take a little phthalo green and add it to this yellow. So we got a little phthalo green, a little yellow, a little sap green. Then here we'll just push, get that little ridge of paint. Okay, and that's what we got on our brush. So we got at the tips there. That's what we're looking for. So let's come in here. We're gonna tap. More color. Tap, tap. That's better. Okay, good. All this out a little more. And this line here. And just tap, 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 tap. All right, I like that. Okay, and maybe we're going to come to the other side. See what we can squeeze in here. So this tree is going to end about here, so we can come here. And then with a fresh line of paint, we can bring this down like so. Over that dark. More paint. Not sure what we're going to do here. We're going to have some bushes and stuff, so I don't want to go over this too much. We'll see. Okay. There we get a nice lush grass around there. To tame this yellow down a little bit, I'm not digging it. So I'm going to take my filbert, this yellow here. So we'll get some of that dark. Let's come over here. And we're just going to get rid of that. And then come back with a little bit of this green like we had on the other side. Back. Okay, I think that's a little bit better. This is sticking out a little bit too much for me. All right, now let's come back and put some tree trunks in a couple of these. So just get a little roll of paint. I'll come in here and just touch. Just touch. And just in a couple spots. Doesn't have to be the whole tree. Good. little crooked there. That's okay. Any of these you don't like, we can cover up. A little thick here. Just come in with my black. Let me get rid of that. There we go. A little thick. Let's take a little bit of him away. And let's see, he's a little thick back here too. So we just get rid of. Let me clean it up a little bit. We won't see too much of these back here. Just a little bit. Good. Okay. Oops, I missed one. You people got to remind me when I miss it. He needs some. Now to highlight these. All right, so I cleaned my filbert, and I still have a little bit of thinner. I pretty much shook it out, wiped it down, but there's still a little residual thinner in there, so we'll use that to thin our paint for our highlights. So let's go into this green that we had the grass and just tap that. We'll see what this looks like. Let's try one back here. That's fine. Maybe add a little more green. Maybe a little bit darker. Not much. And back here, just touching in a couple spots. Good. Okay, let's come to these guys right here. Darker down at the bottom. Good. So what I like to do is come down, since our light's from coming from the right, I need to come down on the right side of the tree with a couple of these. Darker down here. And then the back side is just whatever paint you have left over in a couple spots. Not too much. We don't want too much back there. All right. And these front trees, I'm going to put a little more yellow. Let's see what it looks like. Not too much more. Maybe brighten them up a little bit. So again, just push. Come to the top here. Touch. when that paint stops coming off, reload. You don't want to have to push here. Darker at the bottom. Do want to bring a couple of these out a little bit. And then again, if there's any of these that you don't like, you can come back with a little filbert brush and you can punch in and form these kind of however you want. Just come in and add a little dark here and there. Adding some dark back. And you can form it how you'd like. Again, a little too bright. Just come underneath, add a shadow to it. Felt like he was naked over there. All right. Okay, we'll come to the other side. I'm gonna get just a hair of the thinner. Dab it on a towel. Telling you, a little bit of thinner goes a long way. Okay, let's come over here. Touch. Color. And lighter on the back side. Okay. This last one. Color. It'll be darker down here. All right, I think those are good. And I think after looking at this, I want to add a couple more trees. So let me get my filbert. I'm going to go on the side over here. Once again, so I'm going to clean out my brush. Wipe it. All right. I'm going to close off these ends a little bit. So we're going to load up again our filbert brush. So let's come over here. Maybe this tree is going to be a little shorter. We'll put them behind him. Just to cover this edge. Let's come up here and touch. Come down. Wrapping around and just kind of filling this in. Yes, I should have done this before, but that's okay. That's better. That closes off that end, and we'll do the same thing on the other side. He's just a little shorter. Maybe he's here. Come in. So you can see I can't draw a straight line. So let's tap him into existence. He's behind him. Redo. We'll touch up some of these highlights on this side. Just trying to fill in here. There we go. Perfect. And we need to highlight him. All right, come up here and just touch him here. That's about all he needs. And bring this one back over him. And the same thing on this side. He doesn't need too much. Okay, now we can decide where we're going to put our bushes. Let me go back and add a little bit on this back side. Not much. Just a few dabs. Just so he's got something back there. Okay, that's better. All right, so now we're going to add some bushes. So I'm going to dip into some of my liquid white. I just dip the tips of the bristles in there, and then I like to kind of put it off to the side a little bit here with some, obviously a good amount, still in my brush. Okay. Now we're going to go in, let's pull through this yellow. We're going to come through this yellow, and we're going to add a touch of phthalo green. Makes a nice green bush, or yellowish green. So we'll pull through this. Okay, and then we'll start tapping. I'm going to go get a little more of the phthalo green. Just a little more. Tap, tap. What you want to do is load that top corner full of paint. See that? Good amount of paint in there. Don't be afraid to load it up. Tap, tap like crazy. That paint in there. Now let's come over here. We want to make this a little brighter than the tree. So maybe we're here. You're just touching. And then we'll go a little lighter on the back side. And then to that, we'll add a little more green. So the same color, but a little more on the green side. I'm gonna tap that in there real nice. Let's see what this looks like. We'll come over here. Off into that like that. I'll tell you what we're going to do on that one. Let's take let's take a take this 2-inch. I'm going to go into a little bit of thinner. Okay, dipped in a little thinner, wiping on a paper towel. Okay, and then we got a little left in the bristles, so we'll come to this red right here. And we're just gonna get the tips here. Want a good amount so that when we touch it comes off. Just tap that in there. That should be enough. Now we'll come over here, we'll put little red flowers. Tips there. There. I like that. Okay. Now we'll go back. I'm going to wipe my brush. I'm going to dab it real good. Get my green off. And come back into that yellow. We'll add a little bit of that. A little bit of the Indian yellow. Just a touch. Just tap it. Come in and grab this. Maybe a little bit of the ochre. To change the flavor a little bit, tap, come underneath here. Like that. Okay. Over here, I'm going to put in some rocks. Let's go to the other side. Let me go to the other side, tap this and brush out a little bit. Actually, let's put a little bush right here. Just on that side, just to brighten him up a wee bit. Now we'll go into some phthalo green and some green. There's a little bit of yellow left in the brush. Pulled out some of the sap green, and we're adding a little phthalo green. And again, we're just going to tap that in real nice. All right, we'll come to this. Oops. And we'll come up here. And on this side of the bush, or the put a little tree, I should say. Put a green bush here, maybe one here, a little more color. Like that. A little more color. Again, we're going to come back. We'll add some, maybe some red flowers to this guy. There. And let's add what we can go two-sided on this brush. Right, so let's go over here and we'll come to the yellows that we had going. So we're going to tap some of this yellow here. Get a little yellow on there. So we got red on one side and yellow on the other. So we'll come up here We'll just have a couple yellow flowers on the screen. Hair sticking out there. Maybe we'll leave him just green down there. I think that will work. Well, let's see here. Then I'm going to grab an oval brush. Let's grab an oval. There we go. Okay, oval. And I'm going to go into some of this dark. And right here, I'm just going to put in a little bit. Up a little higher. Like that. Another brush. Okay. And I'm just going to go maybe into this again, a little of this phthalo green, green-yellow mix that we had. And just touch. You know what? We'll brighten that up a little bit. A little bit of yellow. Oops. Touch him all the way to the end there. A little darker on the back half. Okay. Good there. All right, now I think I'm going to take my knife. And we're going to take some of this, just make a pile of this stuff here. A little sienna, a little umber, grab a little of this ochre in there, and a little bit of white. And loosely mix that so you get a nice marbled appearance. We'll put some rocks in. Cut across. Get a little roll. Let's see where we want to go. Maybe here. Just kind of. Over land, sticks up a little bit like that. We'll put some stings around him, and I think we'll do the same thing on the other side in some spots. Maybe this guy comes off here. That. Okay. Then we come back with our greens. Maybe set this guy in a little bit. There. darker on this side. Some phthalo green and green, and little yellows. One more phthalo. Let's see. We're just going to kind of set him down. A little bit of grass, bush there. Come back. Let's jump over to some red. Actually, you know, I'll do that last. Let's keep going with this brush. Let me see here. Ochre. So again, I'm just going back and forth here from greens, yellow, ochre. Let's see what we got here. This guy's right there. Happen. Let's see here. Just sitting there by himself. Phthalo. All right, now that I'm going to do that, let me close this in a little bit. Tap in some grassy areas right there. Coming out of this rock. And then on the other side here, be a little bit darker. A little grass in between here. Set him down a little bit. Now, I'm going to rinse off, or rinse, I'm going to wipe off this brush that had the greens. Get all that paint off. Wipe it good. Nice big red bush, so we're going a little thinner. When I do red bushes, it's always best to use thinner instead of liquid white, because if you use liquid white, then you're going to have a pink bush, and pink bushes are fine, but if you want a red bush, oops, just got paint all over my hand. Let's wipe that off. Tell you what, I go through a lot of paper towels. Just gonna clean this. Okay. And just from cleaning it, the residual on here is more than enough for your red paint. It's time for a red bush. I love a red bush. So tap in this red. Straight red. Straight red. Okay. Get lots of paint at the tips of the bristles. I like to splay them out. So maybe here. We'll start here. Reload. It's off there. Okay, that's good. I like that. And then to match them up, let's come over on this side. And we will touch some flowers on top of this green bush in a few spots. Okay. All right. I think that might do it. I may come back and tinker with it a little bit, but I do believe that's all she wrote. So thank you again so much. This was a lot of fun to paint. Give it a try and show me what you've come up with. And I'm going to sign it here in a minute and be on my way. All the best, folks. Thanks for painting with me. Take care. All right. I hope you guys had fun with that. Again, I had so much fun painting it. Please message me, show me your pictures, show me what you've done. I'd love to see your progress and help out in any way that I can. Hit the subscription button down below, notification bell, get notified anytime I put out some new content. Again, thank you. It was great having you, and we will see you on the next one. All the best.